Hello, dear viewers, and welcome back to Let's Play Dungeon Crawl Stone Soup. We return after a previous unsuccessful run this evening. I won't spoil for you which one it was, but it was a little embarrassing. But we return, and we're going to try something new, I think. I'm going to go with Igor as a name. I like Igor. And I kind of want to do a sneaky, sort of a sneaky, dodgy ranged character. Maybe an arcane marksman, possibly. So I'm going to check out some aptitudes here for ranged weapons. Here we are. I don't want to do a centaur. They're too bulky and clumsy and whatnot. High elf is a strong possibility, actually. Yeah. I feel like high elves used to not have an experience penalty. Ah, well. Negative one experience is, as you can see, the most common, actually. Neutral experience gain is less common than a penalty, but there are a few. I'm toying with the idea of a halfling. I feel like they have generally good. Yeah, they have reasonable aptitudes. Their spellcasting isn't. Well, their spellcasting skill specifically is pretty abysmal. There's spell schools, there are some decent ones, but mostly they have a slight bonus of stealth, which I suppose is fine. Yeah, plus ones across the board on those. They level more rapidly, so we could go for that would be stronger in the early game, early to mid game. What else? They are very proficient with throwing slings, which I believe cross-train, actually. I don't know. Not sure on that one. But, yeah, let's give it a shot. Let's go with a halfling. Igor seems like a reasonable halfling name. I mean, he could be a ghoul, possibly, but I don't know. Ghouls are weird. All the undead races are weird. I think the mummy is the least weird, but they're still weird. Okay, so aptitudes again. Spellcasting specifically. Charms are okay. So that's arcane marksman is a possibility. Translocation's also okay. So, as long as we didn't mind having a limited number of spell levels and a limited mana pool, we could go with an arcane marksman. We would have a reasonable access to haste, to portal projectile, to various teleportation effects later on, much later on. Which I feel like is a reasonable thing to do. And with the experience boost, the fact that we're spreading ourselves slightly thinner experience-wise by having to drop some into spells somewhat early on, makes it a somewhat attractive option. I also just, I like spells in general. They change the rules. They let you cheat. I mean, it's magic. You're bending the fabric of the universe to suit your whim. That being said, I kind of want to play an assassin with a blowgun. They added, with the revamp of ranged weapons in 0.15, blowguns seem a little better. And I think they use the throwing skill even. Yeah, let's do it. Let's try it out. Okay, so skills. Yeah, cross trains with slings. And this is something new with 0.15. Cross training used to make the cross train skills easier to train until they reach the same level as your primary skill. But they changed that. Now it just directly puts experience points into the cross train skills, which is kind of neat. I don't know that I like it. I mean, it makes the game easier because your decisions as to where to put your experience are less crucial throughout the game. You end up with a wider variety of trainable skills or of trained skills. So from a challenge perspective, I don't like it all that much. It takes some of the fun out of long-term planning of a character. On the other hand, I get the feeling like I'm going to completely change my tune once I'm level 25 and I have 20 levels in short blades and I find a really cool long blade that I want to wield, and I can do so immediately in this version, whereas in another I would have had to have dumped a whole bunch of experience into it, perhaps unnecessarily. So, that being said, there is one thing that I want to point out, which is the differential in aptitude. This is an excellent example of it. You can see that short blades and throwing are both at the same level. The cross-train skills, long blades and slings respectively, are at 1.1 and 1.7, and that is the difference between a 0 aptitude and a +4 aptitude. Roughly a 50% increase in effectiveness. Seems like slightly more than, or perhaps it's rounded up. Regardless, aptitude does make a big difference when it is that much of a spread. +1, -1, not a real big deal. It may cause you to spike in power slightly later than you would like, but it's not too bad. Whereas, a +3, +4 can make a major difference in your play style, in your game all around. Okay, so we want to turn off fighting. I'm not particularly pleased that we started with points in that, actually. But that's fine. Dodging, we don't want right away. I think I'm okay with the spread, short blades, throwing, and stealth. This is thinner than I normally start a character, but two things make me feel comfortable with it. First, throwing and short blades both have a +3 aptitude, which is insane. It's very good. And so, 33% is going to be closer to, 45% or so. And we could even enhance that effect by doing this. Actually, I like this better, even. Damage is important early game. The other reason why I feel okay putting points into stealth is because, one, it's very useful for an assassin. Stabbing is cool, it's fun, it's very satisfying to just walk up and slay a creature in one blow. And stabbing is based off of your stealth skill as well as your relevant weapon skill. So, stealth actually is a damage ability for us. It directly contributes to our success in killing things, rather than just being a very useful thing to have for survivability. It is that as well, but it serves an offensive purpose. So, we're good with our skills. What do we have? We have a +0 blowgun. Okay, so we have some poison needles, and we have two curare tipped needles. Curare is a nerve agent, for lack of a better term. It poisons the target. It puts them out of breath. It makes it hard for them to breathe. So breath weapons or recitations are impossible, and it slows as well, which is really neat. And the poison is particularly strong. It's just a very powerful effect. stones we will want to pick up. In fact, I think I will turn that on because, yeah, sling bullets and stones. Because one interesting change in 0.15 is the lat kill a python. The removal of weight. There's no longer... Oh dear. There we go. Okay. Yeah, that's why poison needles are cool, because you can just shoot one and run. And, yeah. We would have died otherwise there. Anyway, the removal of weight is... I don't know. It's kind of nice, because there are some races where you are basically required to put your first... 3 or 4 points, stat points into strength just to be able to carry the basic necessities. Regardless of things like stat drain, you just had to have 7 or 8 points. So if you were playing like a deep elf and started with a strength of 4 as a wizard, you just couldn't put any points into intelligence for a while, which made it much harder in the early levels when intelligence is really, really important for your damage and your spell success. So the removal of weight does make some of those frail builds more viable, which is cool. I like that. Again, I dislike the decrease in complexity and planning. Like I now I'm just turning on picking up slings and stone bullets, which means I'm going to have a bunch of junk in my inventory that I'm probably not going to want later on. But there's no penalty for carrying it around, and crawl is a hard game, so I'm going to do it. So I feel like they kind of whiffed on that one. I think they were aiming to get rid of an annoying factor of the game, and instead have replaced it with a little bit of the skulldudgery that they're trying to avoid with this, the grindiness of, you know, picking up everything you see and then having to micromanage what exactly you carry. So they won some, they lost some on that one. We'll call it even. And again, your mileage may vary. You may just hate having to have kept track of carrying things, and so it's a wholly beneficial change. But was there a sling? Am I imagining things? No, he was just throwing rocks at us like a peasant. Stuff on level 1 you can basically just bash down regardless of what weapons and things you have. Okay, so another turning point. I think I want to go a non-spellcasting route with this character. My last few wins have all been... I don't know. I think I won with a purely strength-based melee character at one point. But generally, my wins have been with sort of hybrid characters that have a reasonable skill in a weapon and then a bunch of spells. Which I kind of want to switch up. I kind of don't want to cast spells this time around. I want to rely on good tactics, good item usage, and good deity manipulation to win. That's the challenge that I'm setting for myself with my next victory attempt. I decided that between the last video and this one. I don't want to cast spells if I can help it. I mean, I will certainly pick things up and memorize them, given the opportunity. If it's free, I'll do it. But I'm not going to go out of my way to learn them. This is a prettier looking robe. Oh, with a very interesting tile graphic. Yeah, we'll we'll wear this rather absurd looking bright white robe around as an assassin. It has no actual effect on gameplay, so we'll just be the Liberace of assassins. I'm okay with it. They removed contaminated meat. You can now eat the flesh of sentient beings and gross cockroaches the same as anything else. Stabbity, stabbity, stabbity. That's why being an assassin is cool. For most other characters, that would have been a deadly situation. But instead, we just waltzed through it like a boss. Let's see. Oop. What did I do? I don't know. Oh, I hit the help button. Anyway. Yeah, so our slings is, you know, it's training up reasonably well by itself. I do want to turn off throwing, though, for now. I feel like our throwing is fine. We're not having to use our blowgun a whole lot, and in circumstances like this, where we had to, I'm not particularly worried. Yeah, whereas our melee capabilities, I think, are much more tenuous. That's not really the proper word there. Oh dear. Took a little bit of a risk there with some extra poison to try and get the snake poisoned. Poison is a very powerful effect in the early and mid game. I think in the past I have underestimated poison. I certainly have never played a Venom Mage. Let's pick up a short sword. It's still a short blade, so we still have reasonable skill with it, but before our stealth really takes off, Be poisoned. Well, we're still in the sort of bashy stage where we can't really sneak up on many things with any reliability, that is. It's nice to have a higher base damage weapon, something that you don't have to rely upon stabbings to be useful. That being said, I'm still keeping the dagger equipped for dungeon level 2 just because it's... how do I want to approach this situation? I want to go around. Oh, but I'm receiving a phone call. So we'll end this video here for now, and I will see you next time, dear viewers.